Hello and welcome. Hello and welcome back to. Hello and welcome back to my garage. Today in the shop, the Opel Corsa. If you have seen the last video about this car, when we did replace the. What did we replace? Oh yeah, the multi-belt and pulley, or the pulley alone. So, if you have seen that video, then you do know that the brakes were really, really worn. So that's what we're going to do now. We're going to replace the brakes. This car came with a variety of different kinds of brakes. So be sure that you have, of course, the right one for your car. And as you can see, this one is a solid disc brake. These came also in vented, and I also believe in different sizes. Also, there are, if I remember correctly, two types of calipers on there. So be sure to check what you have on the car. Not always when you put in the VIN number or the registration number into one kind of software, pops up, this is what you need to have. Unfortunately, nowadays you get these things are probably on the car. So yeah, I know some cars it is definitely worse than others. One of the cars that is absolutely the worst is Dacia. Dacia, you can, I do believe you have, if you have the first Logan cars, then you can have 15 different combinations between discs and pads. But of course, that is how the car is built, because to be honest, at least the first Logans were just leftover parts from Renault. So everything that Renault had laying around and they not use it anymore, well, put it on a Logan. And if that's depleted, then put this on it and then put this on it. So yeah, it's really worse at with those cars. Of course, I had already removed the wheel and I did check what kind of brakes are on there, so I did order just one set. If I didn't have that, then I would probably have bought two or three sets, and of course the wrong ones would be have sent back to the parts supplier. If you have everything off there and you want to put it on there and you don't have the right stuff, it is really annoying because you have to build it all back and wait for parts again. So no, that's not going to happen. And if you have the luxury, the best thing that you can do in those cases is just remove it, go to your parts guy, says, here, I need new ones. And then he gets you the right parts. But of course, if you order it on the internet, that's not a thing. So, back to the car. Well, the intro has been long enough. Let's get working on the car. Well, here we have the caliper, and as you can see here, the piston is quite expanded. But because we're going to replace the discs and the pads itself, I don't mind putting a screwdriver behind here. It makes your life a lot easier to, well, push the piston back now. Okay, that's weird. Because you're going to destroy the pad if you want to reuse it. It is all the way back now. As you can see, the sliding isn't working as it should be. So we definitely need to look into that. This cradle has to be sliding on these pins that are seated right here. So normally this should go back and forth. It does a little bit, but we have to re-loop these anyway. What I most of the time do is just do the below one. Hmm.
because you can now flip it up and just push it aside. And as you can see, this one is sliding back and forward just fine, but this one is stuck. Just be sure that you put your caliper somewhere safe. Don't let it hang like this. Just put it somewhere there, or get a bungee cord or something. So now let's remove the lower one. Yeah, it was just a big vacuum pump right here. Well, we're going to clean that up. This is just, of course, a mental note. There's a hump right here that goes to the back, because this one doesn't have a hump. And if we got our new ones, as you can see, one of them has a hump and the other one doesn't. So the hump goes to the back. Well, the slide indicator says that there is enough life left on the pad, but I definitely don't want to get it to, well, where that indicator is showing. I think this is thin enough, especially if you put them side to side with the new one. Our kit came with new clips. Be sure you can reuse them, but most of the time when you get squealing sounds when braking, most of the time these things are bad. Get a kit that is has these included, or get these separate, but be sure if you're in a pinch you can reuse them, but rather not. Next up, we need to remove these bolts. That's for the cradle or the carrier of the caliper, and those are held in place with those inner Torx. The car is full with these Torx bolts, so you need a inner socket for that, or inner Torx socket, and this is a A18. So if you own one of these cars, be sure that you have a full socket set of those E things. That's not going to work. Stuck? Yeah. That thing is stuck. Well, I need more leverage. Let's do the other one as well. Probably go stuck also. Well, this one is dead bad. So. To get a disc off, we have to remove this Torx screw. And this is a T30. And it's off. Be sure you clean the hut before you put on the new disc brake. If you don't clean it, the chances are there is some gravel behind it or behind the mating surfaces, and you can get some wobble when you try to brake, so you feel that in your well, pulsing in your disc brake. So, just take your time, just clean it up. And get your Weiss heirloom and just wipe it all off. And as you can see, there's already some ceramic grease on there. So the guy before me, well, did probably the same thing I do now. Just get a coat of that stuff on there. And as you have seen, the disc brake didn't get stuck. It just popped off really easy. And that's why we do it. Because those discs can be really stuck on there. You have to smash them off there. And if you only want to remove the bearing, then you also have to replace the discs. Because, well, hammering on the disc brake is something I'm definitely not comfortable with. Not if I want to reuse it, at least. So, let's see if there is a new bolt in the kit. There isn't a new bolt, but to be honest, the kit I got from my parts supplier was already opened and they, well, the boxes are completely smashed. And as I said in my last video, be respectful with boxes. Well, this guy didn't do it. I don't mind it that much, of course, but the chances are that there were new bolts included, but has been lost in, well, I don't say they were included, but the chances are that they were. The next thing what you want to do is clean up the saddle, especially where the, well, those clips are getting into for the pads on both sides. And what we're going to do, of course, is clean these bores. Are they corroded? Well, they're not corroded, but as you have seen, the bottom one, well, has vacuum, so that's a bit unusual. Just get yourself a steel brush, put a lot of brake cleaner on there, and start wiping. The brake cleaner I use to keep control of the dust. And of course it helps clean. If you want to be really fancy, you can of course just put it in your sandblaster. Well, that's a direct translation. Let's see how I'm going to clean those bores. I do have a set of these pipe cleaners. I use these for engine rebuilds, for oil galleries and stuff like that. Because I am currently rebuilding a engine. I was trying to rebuild an engine. That was about 1.5 years ago. But because I needed, some new pistons for that engine, I luckily could order them, because it is a, well, an uncommon car, at least over here. I had to wait almost a year for a set of new pistons. So the pistons are now here, luckily. But now I have to pick up the pace to get it done. And of course, I'm not going to wait a year. So I'm already starting on some other projects that has to be finished first before I'm going back to that engine. As you can see, there is a fret sealant on these bolts. And there is definitely enough to, well, for another time, and that's... I'm not really using a lot of fret sealer because most of the time, just like this, there's still enough on there. So it just doesn't help that much. But because I have some new fret sealer, I just wanted to try that out. Most of the time you just use too much. And well, I did that also. Most of the time a drop is enough, more than enough. But for some reason it's just a satisfying feeling just to dab it all the way around. And these two need to be torqued to 100 newton meters. The other way around is better. So I'm just using some silicone paste. Never use a grease or something in here. Always some silicone. And of course loop the shafts also. Yeah, there's a joke in there. Oh, I almost forgot the little condom. So. Is it by design that it's making vacuum? Well, it is now floating as it should be. Well, let's put on this one already. So next up, of course, we're going to clean up this one also and put it in there, but that's not what we have to do now. Let's put in those shield thingies. Just have a good look how they go. In this case, the well, little way thing is has to go to the outside like this. So the flat side is on inside and the little lip is, well, towards the camera. To the front of the car. So here is that little way thingy. So that one has to go if it's upside down. So this is going to the inside. This is going towards us. So this one has to go right here. Be sure that you seat them well, or else you cannot get the bat in there. Okay, now it's a little bit of a controversial thing. Some say put some ceramic grease on there, some say don't. I'm a bit old school, I like to do that, but they do not recommend you it anymore. So yeah, what we're going to do, we're going to do this as a test case, just put it in there and let's see if the customer or, well, my friend comes back with squealing brakes. Or am I going to use just a little bit of grease? I'd rather do that with one of my own cars. Nothing too much, of course. And as mentioned before, the one with the hump goes to the back. Be sure that they can move freely. This one can. If not, then clean the bracket better underneath those shims. Just scrape it with a screwdriver or something. So the one without a hump goes towards us or at the front. just like that. And this one also still moves freely. So now we can put back the caliper. So let's clean up the pin and of course use some silicone paste. And we can slide it in there. Well, that's better. Maybe it was just because there was I put in just a blob of silicon that it's made a, well, just a piston. So now it's going over there quite nicely. And we, now we have to line up the lower one as well. Maybe I have to rack this one also a little bit, so it does spread around. Maybe I did just put in a little bit too much. That's also, of course, a possibility. That's better. And the kit came just two bolts, so two new bolts. So they do expect you to, well, not remove this one, because one, of course, is for the other side. And this one has to be torqued down to 27 newton meters. Also, the size has changed. That's a bit annoying because the old one was 12 and the new one is 13. I don't trust this. It just feels like it doesn't tighten at all. It just feels like it's almost there. It's almost there. It's almost there. But I just don't trust it. Let's see what's happening. Well, the bolt looks fine. The problem is that it is still turning, even if it isn't really 27 newton meters yet. It just feels so wrong. You know what I mean? And it is also not that it is a stretch bolt. It doesn't have the shoulder for a stretch bolt, at least. Also, the torque instruction doesn't say it is a stretch bolt. Maybe I feel comfortable with the old ones in there. Let's see how they behave. That's better. That's way better. Now the, as you can see, it just hits it. And if I want to turn it further, it definitely is going higher. As you can see. So I'm not really comfortable in using those bolts. Now, of course, torque it to the right spec. 27 and a little bit. So these two bolts are going in the bin. I do have a feeling those are meant to be stretch bolts. Well, the workshop manual doesn't specify stretch bolts, so I don't know how to torque them. Most of the time with stretch bolts you have to torque them to, let's say in this case, 20 newton meters, and then with 45 degrees more, something like that. But because I don't have them, I cannot use these bolts. And also the instructions with the pads that came with the pads don't have any instructions in there. Well, I lied. There are the instructions, but there are no numbers in there. That's really a shame. Because the official instructions are quite good. You don't see that very often with brake manufacturers anymore. The only thing they could do better is add the torque specs. Clean up everything with brake cleaner. And of course, don't forget the backside. So one side is done. I'm going to do the other side. But one thing that you have to be certain of, before you're going to drive the car, press the brakes a couple of times. Even the instructions say so. Because the pads have to be seated to the discs, and that takes a couple of pumps. So just pump it a couple of times and then you're golden. So I'm put back there on the tire, I'm going to do the other side, and well, then we're done.
And there you have it, how to change your disc brakes on a Opel Corsa Model C. Was it necessary? Yes. Was it as bad as I have seen on, well, my sister-in-law's car? Definitely not. But yeah, it's a good thing we did this. So, about those bolts, I thought about it a little bit. Could it be that they made them intentionally like this? As you have seen on the torque wrench, they did crap out around that 27 newton meter mark. Could it be that they made them so you don't have to have a torque wrench? So you can just, and they will be always the right torque spec? Maybe? I doubt it, I never heard of it before, but what I found interesting is why it crept out at that 27 mark. It is something to think about, and it's definitely something I am going to look into. Because if that's the case, then it is, to be honest, pretty awesome. But I doubt it is. Well, I did install the old ones just because I feel safer that way. But yeah, that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it, or at least learned something from it. And if you did, please give it a like. If you want to follow me around, you know what to do. And I will see you next time. Bye.